Thank you. Dearly beloved friend of the day, you are here today to seek your love with the eternal body of Jesus. I assure you of the prayers of our community that God may pour his abundant blessings on your love and help you carry out the duties of your days. And you, dear brothers and sisters, they ask you to have them in their prayers and accept them as a new couple of Christian community. Did you come here of your own free will to bind yourself forever with the love and service of Christ?
Yes, Father.
Well, did you come here of your own free will to bind yourself forever with the love and service of Christ?
Yes, Father.
Are both of you ready to raise as good Christians and children of God who will give you?
Yes, Father.
Let the lay, since you wish to be grateful for the matrimony, join your right hands, express your intention for God and His church. According to the right of our Holy Mother, the Church,
yes,
do you give yourself to Him as His wife?
Yes,
do you accept Him as your love and as
His
wife?
Yes,
do you take lay here present as your lawful wife, according to the right of our Holy Mother, the Church?
Yes, sir.
Do you give yourself to her as a husband?
Yes, sir.
Do you accept her as your lawful wife?
Yes, sir.
Now, please say together. Grant us, O Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
To be one heart.
To be one heart.
And one soul.
One soul.
On this day forward.
On this day forward.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer.
For richer.
And for poorer.
In sickness,
and in health,
and in health,
until death,
until death,
do us part.
Do us part.
And I, the authority of the church, calling on all those who are present here as witnesses, confirm and bless the marriage to the coming time. In the name of the Father, the Son, and lay around the house. God is in the name of the Lord. Praise God. Let us pray. Bless, O Lord, your servant, Glenn and Lay, with sufficiency of material possessions, with these which these arrays symbolize, so that they may use them to obtain eternal life. Through Christ our Lord. Bless the Lord this ring, which your servant lay and play, who will wear that may ever live to meet your love and have broken voice. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. And now let us pray for the prayer of the faithful. We will go back to us. Pwede na mabalik sa akin.
Thank you.
grayscale.
Lord, you are holy and being the fountain of all holiness. Let your spiritual families get strengthened holy, so that they may become first the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. Before he was given up to death, and death he freely accepted, he took bread and gave it to us. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples, and said, take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. But supper was ended, took the cup. Then he gave the thanks and praise, gave the cup to the disciples and said, take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all, so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory. love your wife as Christ loves his church, and be with her in all fear. At this point, you may ask a member of the family to say words of affirmation, where you can.
Thank you.
Glenn and Lei de la Torre. Father Pete Bellini to say grace before having dinner.
Spirit, amen. Bless us, O Lord, and this gift that we are about to receive. Bless also those who will partake of these gifts. May it bring us health and harmony as we partake of your goodness in us. Bless particularly May and Glenn, that this dinner may inspire them that we are with them in heart and soul and in our prayers. And this will be a happy occasion for all of us to share the bounty of the Lord in the life to come in heaven. This we ask through Christ our Lord. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
So, ladies and gentlemen, dinner is served.
Para lang no. Yan dito sa dinner. Good evening. And tonight, ladies and gentlemen, we celebrate the union of Glenn and Lay and the decision to commit each other in marriage. And we are fortunate enough to be here to witness this very special occasion. I see around that, let's give them a big hand, please. I see around that there are a lot of married people here, married couples, or married people at that, so please don't hide your rings. I can see them from here. And I'd like to just bring out some memories, you know, especially for those married people. If you remember the time that you got married during your wedding, the aisles that were full of flowers, the bride was in angelic white gown, who walked through the aisle, and when you see her, when you see your bride, she has a radiant smile in her face, and you said your I do's, and the mass ended, you rode in your car, you went to reception, all that, I bet you still remember in detail. And at the end of that reception, you were so exhausted, you can't wait till the night is over. But you know, after all that work that you've done, there was a reward waiting for you, and that's your honeymoon. But tonight, ladies and gentlemen, is that night for our beloved couple here, Glenn and Lay. Tonight is a night that they will never forget in their lives. A night that they will always cherish in their memories. And, you know, ladies and gentlemen, if you only know the story of, the love story of our brother Glenn, as we call him in our community, and our sister Lay, you would be awed and astonished on how our brother Glenn had the determination and the perseverance to pursue our sister Lay. You know, he went out of his way, spent so much time, poured out his heart and soul into the pursuit, and even to the point that he had to change his glasses twice. You know, from if you had a grade of 250 in a week's time, it became 1,000. You know, how can you imagine that jump? But he did that all for the love of our sister Lei. But, you know, as one of our brothers have said, one of our friends in the community has said, the courtship does not end in marriage. The courtship does not end in marriage. The courtship even becomes greater, more intense. More love that you have to pour out, more care that you have to pour out in marriage. And tonight, our brother Glenn will have to begin that in a life of marriage with our, with Lei. So, without further ado, we'd like to continue this very special occasion, and I'd like to call on Dino Diaz here to introduce some of our special people to both Bride and the Groom.
Principal sponsors, okay, from the nearest to me, from the farthest right, we have here Consul, Honorable Consul Enrique Benedicto. And just give it to Then he is followed by Honorable Representative Vicente Sandoval. Then he is followed by Mr. Victor Chongbian. Followed by Mr. Benjamin Gotong. One of their sponsors is also Mr. Gonzalo Librando, but he's not here. Then they are followed by the parents of Glenn, Engineer Agustin de la Torre, and Dr. Sotero, and Mrs. Lucia de la Torre. De Belen, and Dr. Amelia de Belen. They are next to Dr. de Belen is Dr. Victoria Acevedo. Then a proxy for Mrs. Perla Michael is Mrs. Norma Pastrana. Then we have followed by Mrs. Virgin Sita Yaptiu. The two other sponsors is Dr. Sally de las Peñas and Mrs. Concepcion Lua. Okay, so Steve, back to you.
And we'd like to call on a representative from the de Belen family to please come and say something in behalf of the de Belen family.
That's Engineer Arnold Concepcion.
Hi, good evening. I'm Arnold. One of the close relatives of Lei from Manila. For the love of Lei, I came over to Manila to represent our family. I even took a bus last month to reach here. Kaya lang, I took a special bus aircon para makarating dito. Anyway, Lei has been close to our family every year. He would spend summer vacation or Christmas at our home. Basta in Manila, usually they go there family. Kasi all of the members are in Manila. That's why she comes over instead of us coming over here to Cebu. And si Lei naging close sa akin, very close. She would tell me love stories, mga love notes niya. Yung mga relationships niya, kikwento niya sa akin. Mga secret love affairs, you know. Then 2 years ago, she called me. Sabi niya, Arnold, I'm in love with this guy. He's so dashing. He's so cool. Guapo ka ayo. And I agree with Lay, the first time I met Richard. It's like Glenn. I went over to Cebu to confirm if Richard Aglen is okay. He's really good. Mabait and good. in behalf of our family, we welcome you, Glenn. Hope you can take care of our baby. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
And now we'd like to call on the representative from the De La Torre family. Henry, please.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen.
Glenn, Lai.
Well, I'm, in case you don't know me, I'm Henry. I'm the second of 12 children, older than Glenn, of course. And I've met Lei only last year. She remembered very well. That was the golden anniversary for my parents and Saul's wedding. And I had the privilege of meeting Lei for the first time, and believe me, my four girls really adored Lei very much. And I remember my four girls, I would think, were instrumental in trying to convince the two to get married, because they pleaded as much as they could, bribe them, whatever they did, I don't know, but they made them promise to get married this year. Unfortunately, we couldn't make it this year for some reasons, but we send a love to you. And Lei, you know we love Glenn very much. He's more than a son to me, or more than a brother, but like a son. So, right now, I guess this is the last day that he'll be close to us and he'll be yours forever. We entrust him to you. We love him. We'll learn to love you too. And we're really proud that you choose to love them and promise your life and to accept the deletories with whatever. You know us very well by now. And in behalf of the Delator family, I'd like to accept and welcome you to the Delator family fans. We love you.
Well, Arnold, right? Yeah, you mentioned about 2 years ago, Lei met Richard. I remember this guy was trying to change his name for a while. He was having problems with his identity. No, really. That was a, you know, like 1 month ago, when Glenn told us that he was, you know, he was preparing about, regarding the marriage and the wedding ceremony, there were so many lasts, you know. It was his last time with us as single when we honored him last Sunday. It was his last time as a single guy to shake our hands, the last time that he would sleep on his bed as a single. So many lasts until this day came. And this day, there's so many firsts. Yeah? The first time that they held hands as married couple. First time that they kissed as a married couple right there in church. First time that they talked to each other as a married couple. And so many firsts and so many lasts.
That's a tenth. And, you know, if you're asking me what I'm trying to drive at, that's a good question because I really don't know what I'm trying to drive at. But maybe what I'm trying to say is that tonight, we are going to close one chapter of Glenn's life and Lay's life and open another chapter of their lives together. And if you read the first page of that chapter that we're going to open tonight, the first line will say, "And they lived happily ever after." So tonight, we will like to make a toast and call on Dino to offer a toast to our dear friends and lovely couple over here.
Wonderful life ahead. May you put God the Lord the center of your family. Through Him, everything shall be is possible and all problems will be encountered. To Glenn and Lee.
I'd just like to say one thing before we go on with the presentation. And Glenn and Lay would be living together starting today, tonight. And they will be doing a lot of things together. But a friend of mine gave an advice, although I'm not married. Her wife gave an advice, because she had problems washing the clothes of her husband. And the clothes would have collar in the, you know, a ring in the collar, you know, that thing that's dirty around the collar. So she had problems washing it and taking it off from the collar of her husband's shirt. She tried all the kinds of detergents, you know, Breeze, Tide, Super Wheel, every kind. But she was never successful until she came to me and said, "You know, I finally did it. I finally know how to wash the ring around the collar of my husband's shirt." I said, "What did you do?" "Well, I started to wash his neck." That's supposed to be a joke, so be charitable to me, please. Oh, okay, we'll have our presentation.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, I would like to tell you that Glenn and Lay belong to a Catholic community called Amigo ng Panginoon. So in honor that the group decided to have a final gift and honor to Glenn by presenting a surprise number. So what I would like to call the brothers and sisters of Ang Lingkod ng Panginoon.